Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Allison Cruz, and today is a fine day to finish this trilogy of horrible performances here in Luigi's Mansion. Dark Moon, the old Clockworks, has been pretty rough for me, all things considered, but last time we entered the Roundhouse Brawl and we took out an ancient sort of poltergeist, and I don't know what his deal was, why he was wasting all of his telekinetic powers and just trying to troll us by stealing a couple of clock hands. We're in a clock-making factory, and he thinks that we really care about that? Apparently we do, but we got him, and we escaped with only a couple of explosions to our head. So it's time to play catch, and we don't know what this entails other than the fact that it's very obvious. Ah, Luigi, just the man I wanted to see. Probably the only man you've ever seen. Not that we have a choice being stuck here in the bunker and all. Anywho, I tried my darndest, but I wasn't able to locate that missing hour hand. Well, what good is anything you have if you can't even find an hour hand inside of a clock-making factory? The periscope can only find paranormal objects, so we're out of luck there. I guess so. But while he was searching, he found some paranormal activity in the Clockworks court. It was very minor, and just probably a few greenies, but we have to start a search somewhere. Okay, you ready, Luigi? Prepare to be pixelated. No, wait, not against my will. I'm not ready. You don't need to cower in fear every time I pixelate you. Well, you rubbing my face in it doesn't help matters any better. You've done this over a dozen times without anything going wrong. All right, I'm going to push the button now. Don't go cowering in fear this time, you hear? Wait, no, I'm scared. Don't do it. All right, whatever you say.
Whoa.
Okay, seriously, what good is EGAD's equipment if you couldn't see a couple of greenies playing with the hour hand that we needed right in the area that he dropped us off in? It doesn't make any sense, but let's go head inside because we now know the Polterpup is back for real this time, and life isn't going to be good for us because we got to chase him throughout the old factory, and I have a feeling that old boy's going to hurt himself. But first, we're going to head over here because it gave us a lovely bomb, and I want to get away from it because he's going to do a mad dash. Thank God. All right, let's hope that we get all of the bars. There we go. Yeah, I'll take it. And I think that's probably it, but this area is actually quite bereft of a lot of collectibles. So, oh my God, that guy gave me 200. What in the world? All right. Yeah, there's not gonna be a lot of opportunities for money collection here, but it is a short enough mission to the point where it probably doesn't even matter. I just wanna be on the safe side and actually have some content to upload for you today because it's just the same as before. We have the greenies searching for the Polterpup. And they cannot find. No, they can't. So, you might think this is just your general, standard, run-of-the-mill sort of capturing the little doggo, and it's just going to be some regular old greenies in our way, but this is where they actually start putting up a bit of a fight, because as of this point... Oh, hi. What are you guys doing? Hey, you want to come down here? They're going to start having shields, and you actually need to start sucking them up in regards to what color shield they have. So that one had a green shield, which means we would have to charge our shot up to the second bar. And it's kind of annoying in that respect, but I guess it's probably not the worst thing in the world. But just keep in mind, they're gonna start having shields now, and it's not fun. So let's head back over here through the workshop, and be careful. Hi, where are you going? Get back here, man. Oh, hi, what is this? No golden greenies? Oh, hi. I see. You had to make an entrance that was quite dramatica. Also, there we go. Anything good? Nothing. Although, let me pull that again. That's not gonna... Okay, that doesn't do anything. Okay. Well, if we use our dark light to search for the Polterpup, you'll see that he's actually in the sewing machine! And now he went directly upstairs, and Luigi is just real ashamed of himself. It's all right, buddy. Don't worry about it. So, woo, hi. Nope, nope. Get out of here. I don't need to be yanking anybody's chain that I don't need to be. Any money? Yeah, I'll take some money. It was a sad face, but I will collect it regardless. So while we could go backwards and up the stairs, you probably want to head over here because there are, I think, just one thing for us to collect, and I think this was just a regular gem, right? So I mean, I guess I'll just check it out. Yeah, just a regular old gem we already grabbed. So we run over here and make sure to grab this lantern. I'm pretty sure this is the only new collectible we can grab in this mission because we can't go downstairs, but it's a boo. Don't you dare call me Gumbu. My name be Jambulaya. You know what? I prefer Gumbu though. So what we could do, where are you, man? Where'd you go?
Yeah.
Wait, wait. I'm in the sand. Oh, you barely moved, didn't you? If we're lucky, we can actually get him to pinball in the corner of the gate here, but nope, not even remotely close to where we wanted to go. There we go. That's what I was looking for. Oh, yeah. Yes, yes. Oh, what? Oh, you're telling me he survived that. Damn, I can't do anything cool around here. All right, get over here, man. Will you just do the thing? Oh, what the? What are you? Oh, you're doing the thing. What? I've never seen that before. What was that? That wasn't an attack. All right, I lost him. He's on the brink of life. Get him. There we go. Good God. That's all you needed. Ugh. All right, get in there. My happy sack is waiting for you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Cool. All right, let's... this might have been what I was unlocking. There we go. That would make sense. So I think we can just come up here because he's in the drafting office. And we can just kind of go around or backwards, I guess. I don't think we can... No, we can't head up through there. The mystery room. And I don't think there's anything special for us either. I thought there might have been a couple of greenies we need to have fought along the way, but getting the gold bone is good also. And in case you guys forgot, that is basically a free one-up in case you manage to lose all your health somehow. I'm not entirely sure how that works, but... Just keep in mind, if you have the gold bone, it's good. And if you make it to the end of the stage with it, it gets you 200 extra coins, in case you're wondering where those keep coming from. So it's always a good idea to at least grab it before you go. Amongst other things, I guess. It's interesting that they added the concept to Luigi's Mansion 3DS. Kind of cool, I suppose. But there is no sign of the Polterpup in that game. So I'm not entirely sure why they did it as a gold bone. Hey, how's it going, buddy? Don't laugh at me, man. How dare you? So you're gonna start going the other way. Still not really a whole lot of space for us to do anything special. Oh, thank you for the heart, because I accidentally kissed a spider and it betrayed me. And actually, uh-oh. Spoopy in here. Nothing. Oh, what the? Hey, excuse me. You're not smart. So blue, we can just do the first phase. First suction in. There we go. All right.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love Luigi, man. All right, well, let's head off over here. And yeah, we could have just gone backwards if we wanted to, but yeah, no big deal. Oh, all right, where you be, little doggo? In the, oh, hey. Okay, sure, just keep on running, I guess. Keep on wasting our time. See how I feel about it. Okay, so we're gonna need to go across the beams again. But I have a feeling it's not gonna go nearly as good as we want it to. So be careful, Mr. Cruz. There you go. Alright. No, don't scare him. Hey, get back here. Well, yeah. Alright. I'm gonna follow you and we're gonna end this mission post haste. Okay. So, of course, the only way we can really go is up through here. Looks like there's money at the end of the hall. Oh my god. Oh, you know what? This room sucks. This room real sucks. Okay, so this is where I got exploded on in the last part. You guys probably remember that because I'm bad. We tried to approach this door and reinforcements everywhere. Okay, so I'm just gonna take care of you guys as fast as I can. Oh, what? Oh, or you could just do that, sure. Fine, I don't care. One of those guys always manages to attack me. And because this guy had a shield, we need to do a triple on him. That's what I thought. So I'll grab that, and if possible, I can still get a triple. Oh, I was a little too early. No, no, are you kidding me? Okay, I grabbed one of them, I think. Or maybe I grabbed, did I grab two of them there? I don't know. This room is the bane of my existence. If we try to head back here, I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, that door's not gonna be of any use to us. It's not rattling, so we don't need to worry about it. All right. So you're gonna head into the cargo room again, aren't you? All right. I suppose we will follow. Not like we have much of a choice. And there's no fights to be had here. Perfect. It's just the way that I love spending my missions. See, I could totally do without these types of missions. Not that they're terrible, but the fact that they just are starting to appear in a way that we literally just did the same progression of rooms, and the game is just gonna make us do it again. It's just like, we're hardly gonna get any money out of it. Plot-wise, it offers very little. And just the sense that it's just one of those, like, the Polterpup is just like a poor excuse for things. It's at this point where we need to sneak as much as we can, and once we get just close enough, splash him and bag him. Kill him. Ugh, yeah. Oh ho. Okay. I am curious though. Oh, it's gonna make me do this though, it looks like. I want to see what is in that portrait, if it's even worth it, which I somehow doubt. In fact, all of this is still going is a little odd. I wonder, has anyone even tried to get this painting? Because I have a feeling it's just not worth it. Most people would probably just want to get to the end, but let's have a look. Let's see if our time being sacrificed as a result of this money was worth it. What is it, 20? Oh yeah, 20. Real worth it there, Mr. Cruz. All right, let's get the hell out of here. I am done. I should probably be editing more of these episodes, but the first part's not even gonna come out for another like 3 weeks. And there we go. Perfect. What a fantastic use of my time. This mission. A-okay. Hello. Nice work, Luigi. That ghostly dog actually did us a favor by snatching the hour hand from those ghosts. I'll bring you back in just a second here. Hold on. Ciao. Yep. Ciao indeed. Oh yes, Luigi time. Yeah, you did. All right, so mission complete. I have no doubts that this is just such a simple. Yeah, yeah. Yep, triple? Yeah, triple rank. All right, I felt almost ready to eat my words there, but we caught the boo. That was the only new thing to grab here, and it's time to get the hell out of here. Yep, get in there, Luigi. Happy to see me, old man. I wish we would stop meeting like this. Welcome back, youngster. Great job up there, as usual. Now would you hand over that handy hour hand? Oh, I forgot we kind of grabbed that, didn't we? Yep, make sure, you know, this doesn't fall into the wrong hands. And the dog didn't chew it up. Because, sadly, it's dead. It was put down, and the antlers sang about it. Yeah. Cool. Also, not to mention the fact that, you know, we're in a clock manufacturing factory. I don't think fixing it would have been that big of an issue. But we know the drill. Let's go and empty our exhaust pipe into this hole and be all that much more happy about it. So, treasure doesn't mean anything anymore. And wait a minute. Happy joyful times no more.
Doggone it, not again. I don't get how that little guy manages to escape from the poltergust. Anywho, we need to focus on finding the last missing clock piece, the rotor.
Wait, there's more? Yeah, we'll need it to actually operate the clock hands, because the way we've been doing it before apparently was not necessary.
Yeah, why don't you take a load off, Luigi?
Yeah, I guess so. Starting to come down with a case of the old Rona. No, skedaddle. I forgot about that little bit of text, but that does it for her time here in Luigi's Mansion. I'm going to play this a little bit more to go catch up on the stuff that we needed to grab in the underground expedition, because Peace at Last is a bit of a lengthy mission as well as the boss for this area, so I think I might end up just having to do some actual practice for once, but join me next time as we confront ourselves with the last piece of the clock in order to scale the tower. And believe it or not, it's going to feature a familiar face, so be on the lookout for that. All right, thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you here tomorrow. Or maybe right now, I guess. No one really watches these after release, anyway, so who knows. I'll see you guys then.